Parramatta, the hot Parramatta. I hope a couple of you have got the zinc or the sunscreen on this morning. I'm sweating lightly underneath this dress, but what a morning to be here to officially kick off season 12 of the Westfield W-League 2019-2020 season. I'm Tara Rushton from Fox Sports. It's an absolute pleasure to be here with you this morning and to be yet again part of the W-League coverage because it's back. It's pretty exciting. We love our women. We love international women that come here and play across the Westfield W-League. And it all kicks off next Thursday at a stadium near here, Marconi Stadium, as the Western Sydney Wanderers go head-to-head with Adelaide United. So season 12, what does it dish up? Well, there are more ways that you can watch the live women in action. You can watch it on Fox Sports, on Foxtel. You can stream it live or on demand on KO, Foxtel Go, Foxtel Now, or the My Football app for all Telstra customers. And it is a very warm welcome back, of course, to our free-to-air partner this season, ABC TV, who will be broadcasting live every Sunday afternoon match, as well as that, the final series. It's been a pretty good, pretty positive week for women's football, I dare say. A week that has been decades in the making. We are stoked. How good. The Matildas equal pay parity for the Matildas and the Socceroos. And I guess it all starts here, doesn't it? It's when young girls that are kicking around the ball in the backyard say, hey, Mum, when I grow up, I'd really like to play and be a Matilda. And you go, yeah, actually, you can. So it all starts grassroots and it takes us through to the Westfield W-League. So we're so happy to be kicking off and officially launching another season here this morning. We've got some of the stars in the house as well, and we'll get a chance to meet them later, and you from the media will have a chance to have a chat to some of the girls and women that are here this morning. To officially kick off the proceedings, though, I'd like to invite up onto the lectern, head of FFA, head of the leagues, Mr. Greg O'Rourke.
Thanks, Sarah, and welcome today to the Bankwest Stadium for the official launch of the 12th season of the Westfield W-League. A very special welcome to all of you. You all have a role to play in our game. A couple of very special welcomes, if I may. Firstly, to Eleni Patinos, the State Member for Miranda, the Parliamentary Secretary for Transport and Roads, representing the New South Wales Parliament, and also New South Wales Premier today, Gladys Berejiklian. In addition to that, I would like to also acknowledge probably one of the greatest Matildas of all time. In fact, our number one Matilda as we see it anyway. And welcome to Julie Dolan, who I can see here as well. This season, once again, will showcase not only the best Australian talent, but the best international talent there is playing this game around the world. We're privileged to have 20 of the 23 Matildas who handled themselves so well in the 2019 Women's FIFA World Cup in France, back joining us in the W-League. In addition to that, we also have players in the W-League that also represented their own countries in that big showcase, the Women's World Cup. Players returning that were from New Zealand, from Brazil, from Norway, from Scotland, and from Spain, who are also there in France, are with us in this season's W-League. The international players bring such a competitive edge to our football code. It allows us to tap into our multicultural roots here in Australia and allow our players to not only travel the world, but to play with some of the world's best. This season, we will see players from over 10 countries represented in the Westfield W-League. In addition to those that I mentioned with the World Cup, we also see players from Ireland, Japan, Serbia, the UK, and also the United States of America. The W-League and the NWSL in America have a very close link. It allows players the opportunity to play 6 months of the year here and then to ply their trade in America, to allow them a full-time opportunity to play football year-round. What we'll see this year is 14, well, we saw last season 14 Australian players play in the NWSL, and this season we're just about to launch. We'll see 25 players from the NWSL play in the Westfield W-League. In addition to that, in their playoff series, what we would call our finals, we'll also see three players from the North Carolina Courage who have all grouped together to sign for the Western Sydney Wanderers this year. And in this very stadium here at Bank West in the week before Christmas, I can't wait to see the Sydney Derby between the Wanderers and Sydney FC, where you'll not only see those players, but probably four or five Matildas as well. I also, in addition to what Tara said earlier, I want to give a nod to what was released by the FFA and the PFA yesterday. For the first time, pay parity for our international players, for our Socceroos and for our Matildas. It is not the last step, it is really just one of the very first steps to make sure that female athletes receive what they're entitled to and pay parity. Not just on the international stage, this is actually part of what we did for the last CBA, which is now effective for this season, to ensure that the men's pay and the women's pay are based on the same principles, the same gender equity principles, that no one athlete, irrespective of gender, will get paid less minimum wage than they would if they were playing in the men's game or the women's game. I also want to talk about what's happening in Asia with our game. This year we'll see for the very first time Melbourne Victory represented in the club's championship. Later this month, Melbourne Victory will travel to what is a pilot program for the Women's Asian Champions League. The men have played in the ACL for many, many years. The pilot program will see that also happening this year for the very first time. Well, Melbourne Victory will also take on the best talent in Japan, in Korea, and in China. I would also like to acknowledge Fox Sports. Fox have been with us from the very beginning, for 12 years. And they are continuing on primetime TV Thursday nights to cover every single round of this year's W League. In addition to that, every other game will be either streamed or broadcast. I thank them not only for this year's contribution, but from being there from the very start. Again, I would also like to acknowledge the return of the ABC, a partnership which we've had before, but we've re-engaged in for this year, which we expect to be a turning point for this game, a turning point to be able to have so many eyeballs right around Australia, turned on to the Westfield W League. Every Sunday afternoon, 4 p.m, you'll be able to see on the ABC the simulcast coverage with different commentators taking our game to all parts of this country. I thank them for that. Finally, I would like to thank the sponsors, which without our sport, without any sport, we couldn't exist. I'd like to acknowledge Westfield, Hyundai, Foxtel, Telstra, Aldi, Bet365, Mitre and Rebel for being part of our team. In particular, I would like to call out Westfield. They have been our naming rights sponsor for 12 years. And without their valued support, we wouldn't be where we are today and talking about the game with such global connections. The season opens in 7 days' time. Tickets are now on sale for all clubs, and I would ask you to check the Westfield W League website for ticketing details. In closing, it gives me great pleasure to introduce a special video message from Peter Allen, the CEO of the Centre Group, the owner and operator of Westfield in Australia and New Zealand. Please turn your eyes to the big screen and thank you for being here today.
Season as a leading sponsor of WA. That's so great to have our partners. rugby league is a place where young females can get inspiration in terms of being the best that they can be. I'm really proud to again be a sponsor of Westfield Rugby League.
Yeah, it's great to have them back on board. Really looking forward to seeing some of that inspiration, as we heard, will kick off next Thursday night at Marconi Stadium. So Fox Sports' commitment to the Westfield W-League this season, again, Thursday night football. Every Thursday night, we'll show a game live and ad break free on Thursday night across the season. Sunday night, we'll show 14 games live and ad break free as well. And we've got every game live and ad break free of the final series as well. I'm a little bit biased, but I think we've got the best team in the bizzo. We've got Adam Peacock calling games this year, Andy Harper, and of course, Brenton Speed, and a host of Matildas join our coverage as well, which we're really excited about. We welcome Georgia Yeomandale, Grace Gill, Kate Gill, Amy Chapman, and Michelle Heyman into the Fox Sports fold. Cannot wait to get their comments, their commentary, and of course their first-hand experience of what it is like to play in the Westfield W-League, make their way up, and of course as well, they're all former Matildas. Well, let's take a look at what you can see on Fox Sports whilst we bring you the Westfield W-League for the season ahead. Yeah, there's a lot to be excited about. Not bad there. You probably saw Sydney FC lifting the championship trophy, and Alana Kennedy got actually knocked out by the championship trophy. That's doing the rounds on the Twitter as we lead into the brand new W League season. We have and we welcome back on board this season ABC TV, and we're going to hear what they have planned for the coverage across the season ahead. I'd like to welcome to the lectern lead commentator for the Westfield W League, Stephanie Brantz.
Thank you very much, Tara. I'd like to start by acknowledging the Darug people, the traditional owners of the land on which we're gathered today, and I pay my respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging. Can I echo Greg and Tara when I say what a week it's been for women's football in this country? I've worked in football media for somewhere around 20 years, and I can't ever recall the momentum behind the women's game being this strong. I think female football in Australia has always been ahead of the curve, with dedicated women's programs in place long before our sporting sisters gained inclusion in their codes through maybe political correctness, marketing agendas, or perhaps it was just correction of oversight. Perhaps we didn't like to blow our own trumpet, or thought we didn't need to, because it's just always been there. And that's true. Women's football has always existed in some form. And it's time we properly celebrated that with these steps toward true gender equality, and that's both across the W League and the national team. It's time we started celebrating. Along with a handful of other nations, Australia is setting standards for inclusivity and acceptance. And as I've got to say, I'm biased as a 2023 FIFA Women's World Cup bid ambassador, I sincerely hope FIFA decides to send the biggest show on earth down under so that we can share with the rest of the planet how well we can do women's football. For now though, the dawn of this new season, on behalf of the ABC, we're absolutely thrilled to have the W League back on the national broadcaster, and combined with the Hyundai A League, are delighted that Australian football has a free-to-air home on the ABC. The ABC has long been a champion of women's sport, and connecting with almost 70% of Australians from the beaches to the bush in the most remote areas of the country, this is a great opportunity to promote football to our diverse audience. We want to engage our audience from the grassroots level up and encourage them not just to watch more matches, but to get more involved in their local community. The ABC is 100% committed to growing a long-term successful partnership with the game. And with that in mind, we warmly welcome back the W-League to our screens. And to all of you, whatever role you play, enjoy the season. It's going to be fun. Thanks.
Yeah, looking forward to bumping into Steffi at one of the pitches across the country and really excited to have ABC on board this season. So we've got a couple of stars in the house and I think it's probably about time that we meet them. There's been a fair amount of movement in the off-season, but who cares? They're all coming back to play in the Westfield W-League, so bring it on. All right, here we go. From Adelaide United, Amber Brooks and Els. From Brisbane Roar, Claire Polkinghorne and Scarlett. From Canberra United, Katie Stengel and Ruby. From Melbourne City, Ali Carpenter and Louie. From Melbourne Victory, crosstown rival Jenna McCormack and Asha. From the Newcastle Jets, homegrown girl Gemma Simon and Sophia. From Perth Glory, Alexia Marino and Ivan. FC, Alana Kennedy and Dominic. And from the Western City Wanderers, Erica Holloway and Michaela. I'm now going to welcome all the players to take a big photo around the championship trophy. So I'll get all the girls to move around and arch a semicircle. I'll get the mascots to come this way. I'll get the players to... You take it away, Erica. I think you'll get them. Thanks so much, ladies and gentlemen. That does conclude our formalities for today. You will get another opportunity because all of our gorgeous W League girls and women, they are sticking around. But thank you so much for heading down to Bankwest Stadium. Of course, we hope to see you down here as the Matildas face Chile on Saturday afternoon. If you can't make it, then just head over to Adelaide. It's nearby. And you can catch that on Tuesday night as well. Remember, you can stream all the games on KO, watch it live on Fox Sports. And we're so proud to have ABC join us on this journey. Bring on Season 12, and thank you so much for joining us this morning.